Hey.
Hey guys.
Welcome to Southern California Comics Weekly Video Update. I'm Danny.
I'm Raph.
As you'll notice, this is not Matt.
I'm not Matt, also known as Raphael. Yes. You can call me Raph though.
Yes, this is Raph. He's my roommate. He's done stuff for the shop before.
Yes, he has.
Have you been in any of these before?
I have. I was a special guest in the background in a previous episode.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, it's been a long time. I mean, my contract negotiations finally got unlog jammed. So here I am again.
Well, your lawyer fell down the well, so.
And then I pulled the log that was keeping him down off and so unlog jammed. But so, thank you for reminding me.
We're here to tell you about comics. What's out this week? What's good? What's notable?
Yeah, some pretty cool stuff.
I'll go first.
Of course.
The last issue of Infinity is out. It's the big Marvel Comics crossover. Space people punching. There's a Star War in it, I think. I ain't read this one yet. I've been keeping up. I don't know what's going on. But this is the last one, and I don't have to buy any more of it.
Yes, contrary to the title, it is a limited series.
Hey, I never thought about that, actually.
All right, I'll go. Yeah. This is a slightly older one, but this is G.I. Joe number 10. You should be able to find it on your shelves by Fred Van Lente and Steve Kurth. This one right here is the end of the Threat Matrix arc. Basically, it's a G.I. Joe. It's not your dad's G.I. Joe. It's actually good. It's funny. It's got a good clip to it. Van Lente's a great writer. And basically, the Joes have received three credible threats inside of the inside of New York at the same time. So all three, they have to break out into branches and figure out which one is the actual credible threat. And it takes it from there. It's real conspiracy oriented. A lot of fun. Lots of bracka bracka bracka, which is the sound of Roadblock's machine gun. So check it out.
That's crazy. Saga number 16 is out. I haven't read this one either. I don't really read comics. I just like talking about them.
Yeah, I like picking them up, but then putting them down after I paid for them.
More entertaining comics. I've probably talked about this before, but my favorite thing about the series is like the opening page, because it's always like a really striking image and usually a joke. This one's got this like guy with a headband and pink shoes and wings, just like jumping towards the camera, going no comment.
That's pretty sweet.
Like, I don't even know what this comic.
Yeah, but I have to start reading
Saga. It's super
Saga.
Entertaining.
I have to start reading Saga, which means you should start reading Saga, because our tastes are similar, you and I.
You and I.
Yes.
We're
not so different, you and I. Okay, I am picking up Pretty Deadly, number 2, by Eva Rios and Kelly Sue DeConnick. I read the first one. It's abstract. It's a little it's a little challenging. Not necessarily rip up in front of a store, in front of consumers challenging. But, I mean, it's very rewarding. Emma Reels is a great artist, and Kelly Sue DeConnick has been writing some of the best comics in a while. Her Captain Marvel is something you should all be reading. It's probably for my money, the best Kip and Tights book coming out right now, to be honest. But it's a Western. It's very poetic. If you like Nick Cave and the Bad Seeds, if you like the proposition, you'll probably dig Pretty Deadly.
Maybe a little El Topo in there?
It was most definitely some El Topo, and there's some hella eye gouging in this one, you guys. So if you're into that shit.
Yeah. Some eyeballs popping out.
Yeah, most definitely.
New number 1 from Dark Horse Comics, Neverending. It's by Adam P. Nave and DJ Kirkbride.
Oh, it's number 1.
What? Yeah, it's by the guys who do Amelia Cole in the Unknown World.
Oh, sweet.
It's illustrated by Robert Love. I haven't read this one yet either, but I am going to give money at it.
Yeah, which you should too.
Yeah, it's about like a Superman type guy over the years.
Uh-huh.
It, like the first page captures him in a couple different decades. Yeah, yeah. Like I didn't know what it was about. I know and like the guys who made it, so I want to check it out. But yeah, looks like it's going to be a fun read. It's only a 3-issue miniseries, so not a huge devotion.
Yeah, not a big investment, time or money wise.
Word.
But you'll enjoy it.
Yeah. Superhero stuff?
Cape and Tights, man.
Yeah, and stuff's fun.
Yeah, speaking of Cape and Tights, this is not it. This is another one I'm picking up. And full disclosure, have not read it yet because it's sitting on my pile at home. This is Hawkeye number 15, correct? 14, sorry. By Matt Fraction, Annie Wu on art. Basically, it's the first part, or part two, part one, of the trading off arcs between the two Hawkeyes. We have Clint Barton on the West Coast, I'm sorry, on the East Coast, back in New York, and we have Kay Bishop on the West Coast. And each one follows them, and Dave Asius, or Aha, still does the art on the East Coast. This is new. It looks pretty good. I mean, so far, every issue of Hawkeye has been pretty infallible. Probably the most clever book put out by Marvel. I would say, you know, it's hard to quantify best because you don't know me that well. But yeah, it's definitely worth a read. Like, it's, I mean, there's a reason that it's got those Eisner nods up and down. Check it out. It's great. I mean, most of you are already checking out, I'm sure. But if you're not, it's findable and it's great.
Yeah, it's one of the most entertaining books.
It really is. And a mutual pick for this week.
Oh, yeah.
You can take it from here.
Black Science number one, Image Comics.
By the god Rick Remender.
Rick Remender and Matteo Scalera. Hey, you know what's interesting about this one?
What's that?
I don't know. I haven't read it yet. But it's by the guys who do Fear Agent.
That it is.
Which is one of the best comics of the last decade or so.
They have their own sign.
I've been reading Remender's work for a while. I became a big fan of his during the Uncanny Avengers era. A little earlier than that, actually.
Yeah.
I read his first book, Doll and Creature. Or not his first, that was the one I read. And then it was a wrap once I bought Fear Agent. I had the omnibus sitting at home.
It's super good. This is basically in the same vein as Fear Agent.
Yeah, if you like Wally Wood, if you like that 50s EC house style of sci-fi and horror and a blend of both. And
yeah, it's
show some of these pretty ass colors.
Oh yeah, there's some like.
Yeah, that's Dean White, who used to color Remender's Uncanny X-Force, and just top of his game stuff too. The colorists don't get enough regard.
Super colorful, harrowing sci-fi adventure stuff. It's gonna be a good read.
Oh yeah, we're both picking it up, and we recommend you do too.
Y'all should check it out.
That's what I got. I only bought 3 comics this week.
If you hear a lot of noise in the background, it's because we're having a crazy sale. Black Friday weekend stuff.
20% off all trades, including discounted trades, half off dollar comics, I believe.
Yeah, half off dollar comics, half off sets. I think there's super cheap toys.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Yeah.
You're getting your Christmas bonus next week. And if you're not employed, you're getting that unemployment check. So what better way to recycle back into the economy?
Blow it all here.
Yeah. Thanks, Barack Hussein Obamacare.
Cool.
All right.
We did. We went through. We went through every book.
You feel good?
Every possible book. I feel good. Do you feel good?
I feel good.
All right. Let's do something else.
Yeah.
Let's talk to somebody. You want to talk to somebody?
Yeah, I can talk to somebody.
All right. Go talk to somebody.
All right. I can talk to somebody.
Just not me.
Well.
You're still here.
I am still here.
Okay.
Excuse me. I'm gonna find somebody to talk to.
Okay. Bye.
Hi, this is Raph again with Southern California Comics. Danny couldn't be here, but I am here with my friend Cade. Cade.
Hello.
Cade, for those of you wondering, is as in?
Like arcade. It's spelled the same, C-A-D-E,
right,
without the A-R.
So Cade is here at the sale, and Cade, what are you looking to pick up here? Or what brings you to Southern California Comics? What are your interests?
My brother, he's a really huge fan of you guys. He likes buying your guys' comics a lot.
Okay.
And so I just come here mostly because I'm interested in The Invincible.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one. That's one I'm catching up on my own.
But. Okay, yeah. Been reading number 18, the 18th volume.
Right. Yeah, it's crazy to think it's come that far. So you can pick that up along with several other trades here at the Southern California sale. What other interests? I mean, they don't just have comics here. I mean, they also have gaming stuff. Are you into the gaming culture?
Oh, yeah. That's for sure. I got my GameStop wristband right here.
Okay, so are you more of a digital gamer, video gaming, or like tabletop role-playing card game? Do you dabble in it all?
Mostly video games.
Mostly video games?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, they do have that classic corner over there, and that's the classic corner with 2Ks, where you can get all the wrestling games you used to play as a kid that you can't find anymore. Mm-hmm. Did you play wrestling games, or what area of gaming do you prefer in video gaming?
I enjoy a lot of the old school games.
Oh, okay.
Like NES, Nintendo Hard,
cool
era.
Cool. All right. Yeah. No, we all love them too, and there's plenty to be got here at Southern California Comics. So, Cade, thanks for talking to us.
All right.
Take care.
All right.